Move on to our next speaker, Dr. Gracelyn Jayarani. She is here to speak about traditional weaning or just a second. Baby-led weaning versus traditional weaning. Dr. Grace completed her MBBS from Savita and then MD Pediatrics from SRMC. To make it very simple for us, I think she is a hands-on mom right now who has been practicing baby-led weaning only for the past 3 months. So I think it's a very interesting and a different topic. We are waiting to hear from you, Dr. Grace.
Thank you, ma'am. So my topic is baby-led weaning versus traditional weaning. Weaning is a process of gradually introducing solids and slowly withdrawing mothers or formula milk. There are two types, traditional and baby-led weaning. Traditional weaning is weaning with purees, porridges, or mashed food offered by caretaker with the help of a spoon. It requires a baby to hold back developmentally because traditional weaning requires only passive opening of the mouth. But in case of baby-led weaning, the baby can actually grab food, take the food towards mouth, chew with the help of gums. Baby-led weaning. Baby-led weaning is teaching the baby to self-feed with the help of finger foods, modified family foods from completed 180 days or 6 months. It has better regulation of intake. Difference between traditional and baby-led weaning. So traditional weaning is spoon feeding with the help of mashed and pureed food, whereas in baby-led weaning, baby eats with hands or preloaded spoons. Traditional weaning is less messy than baby-led weaning. In traditional weaning, caregiver controls the amount of food consumed, but in baby-led weaning, baby has a better control of his or her intake. In traditional weaning, swallowing is more than chewing, but in baby-led weaning, chewing is more than swallowing. For traditional weaning, separate preparation is needed, but in baby-led weaning, we can take food from family part with minimal modification. It is easy to ensure the amount of food taken in traditional weaning, but in baby-led weaning, we can't ensure the amount of food taken. But in baby-led weaning, there is an improvement in fine motor skills. Signs of readiness, completing 180 days or 6 months of exclusive breastfeeding, having lost tongue thrust, able to sit in a tripod position for a few minutes, bringing objects to mouth and showing interest in food when we are eating. Tongue thrust reflex. So it is an extrusion reflex. It is a protective reflex which usually disappears by 6 months of age. When we bring a clean spoon near the mouth, if the baby opens his or her mouth, then tongue thrust is lost. If they push the spoon with the back of the tongue, it is still present. Tongue thrust reflex has to be absent before starting baby-led weaning. Can babies eat solids without teeth? Yes, absolutely. Babies can smash soft finger foods with their bare gums. They can even relish finger foods even before they develop teeth. Principles of baby-led weaning. Non-finger foods like porridges are offered with the help of preloaded spoons. Soft foods and vegetables are offered initially. Harder foods cooked until soft before offering. Sips of water are offered with the meals at the end. Meals should be offered preferentially when parents are also eating, because it can aid in learning through observation. Meals should not be hurried. No fill-up meals to be offered at the end of the meal with the help of a spoon. This is a preloaded spoon. The baby is eating porridge with the help of preloaded spoons. Benefits of baby-led weaning. Sensory stimulation of touch by exploring the food. Baby learns to chew rather than swallow. Baby decides the quantity of food, so baby has the appetite control. This leads to prevention of overfeeding or obesity later. Stress-free, enjoyable, and natural family time. Hand-eye motor coordination is better, and baby gets to practice critical motor and oral skills. There is a positive association with food because there is no force feeding in baby-led weaning. No separate preparation is required, so time consumed is less. Baby learns independence, autonomy, and makes his own choices. This reduces picky eating later on. So appropriate size food should be offered for appropriate ages. This is finger food. Grapes are choking hazard, so it has to be cut vertically before offering. Gagging versus choking. In gagging, child will open mouth, tongue press forward, face will be red. This is a protective reflex to prevent choking. Child will have cough and child will try to take out the food by themselves. So in case of gagging, we should not interfere. Both puree food and solid foods can cause gagging. But in choking, child will be blue, unable to make noise and become silent. We should intervene immediately. To prevent choking, food should be offered as per appropriate size and consistency. Hard foods should be steamed until soft. Loud and red, this is gagging. We should not intervene. White and blue, this is choking. We should intervene immediately. Choking first aid, don't poke blindly or repeatedly with your fingers. If there is cough, encourage coughing. If there is no cough, shout for help. In less than 1 year, we can give 5 back blows. And in more than 1 year, we can give modified back blows. If it's still not relieved, we can try chest thrust in less than 1 year and abdominal thrust in more than 1 year. This is back blows in less than 1 year. Sit down, lay the baby face down along your thighs, support the head, give 5 sharp back blows with the help of the heel in children less than 1 year. This is modified back blows for children more than 1 year. Support your child in forward leaning position and give 5 blows from behind. This is chest thrust in babies less than 1 year. Lay the baby face up along your thighs. In the center, give 5 sharp chest thrust, compressing the chest at least about 1/3. Abdominal thrust, stand or kneel behind the child. Place your arm under the child's arm and around their upper abdomen. Clench your fist, place it between the navel and rib. Now grasp this hand with the help of the other hand and pull sharply inwards and upwards. You can repeat it up to 5 times. This is used in children more than 1 year. Distraction feeding is using various strategies like rhymes, TV, screens, activities, etc. to make babies eat more. This will eventually will become a habit for them. There is more chance of picky eating or obesity later in life. Through distraction feeding, babies can overfeed or they can take lesser. Force feeding, feeding a baby by holding them very tightly. This can lead to obesity and negative impact towards food and picky eating later on. Allergies, the earlier we introduced allergens, there is less chance of allergies. Introduce allergens one at a time, fish, milk products, soy, peanuts, or some of the allergens. Cow's milk we have to introduce after 1 year of age to reduce the incidence of cow's milk protein intolerance. Also, cow's milk has high sodium content. It can also damage the mucosal lining. 90% of brain development happens within 2 years of life, so we have to give iron-rich food with vitamin C to aid iron absorption. No salt, no sugar for babies below 1 year. No salt because their kidneys are still developing. Other than natural sweeteners like fruits, salt, it is better to avoid salt in sugar intake for babies below 1 year. And biscuits contain maida, preservatives, emulsifiers, baking soda, and baking powder. So it is not advised. Up to 1 year of age, even sips of water is sufficient at the end of every feed or meal. Open cup, we can offer water through open cup. Oral hygiene is extremely important after each meal. So raising a happy eater, be it a traditional weaning or baby-led weaning, we should allow the baby to touch, explore the food. We should allow them to make mess so they'll be less messier in the future. We should offer variety, texture, consistency, color, shape, and different foods. We should not repeat a single type of food just because they are eating it happily. We should not interfere in the middle of the meal. Do not force feed or distract feed. So I'm showing some of the videos. This is a 6-month-old baby relishing watermelon. This is open cup drinking. He is drinking water. He is 7 months old. Here he is enjoying our traditional medu vadai. He is biting with his gum and enjoying the vada, and also he is enjoying the nature. He is now exploring the texture. Here you can see the baby enjoying greens with his pincer grass at 8 months. Thank you so much. For more updates, follow us regarding baby-led weaning. Hope you will spread the word around to all the mothers. Thank you so much.
Was very interesting, Dr. Grace. I think we were the kind of moms we forced the, what do you call, the distraction feeding or force feeding. So I guess in this type of feeding, how would you know if the child has had his fill? I mean we have, as mothers, we always think, okay, so much the child must have. How would you know the child has his fill?
Yes, up to 1 year of age, till the breast milk is the main source and solids are supplementary, I'll make each bite nutrient dense and energy dense. Even if the child takes few bites, I'll make it energy rich or nutrient rich.
Okay. Are there any guides to this for us to look upon?
Yes, you have solid starts. They have everything regarding to baby-led weaning.
Okay. I guess patience is the key. I mean, patience on in part of the parents and the mother and the caretaker is the key here. Yes. That's any questions from our audience?
One comment, madam.
Please, sir.
Yes, sir.
When the child is taking something into his mouth, that doesn't show the child is having enormous appetite. It is only exploring the any object with his tongue.
Yes, it is, sir. Not slowly they will learn eating, sir.
Eating.
Yes, sir.
There is a question from Dr. Priyanka. She's asking, should we start with boiled vegetables based to diets?
Initially, you can start with the fruits, then steamed vegetables, and later on, you can slice them into a thin
strips
manner, and then you can offer. Yes.
Okay.
I had a point when this child was taking this medu vada. I was a little bit worried. You know, it's a bit of a choking. It's a possibility, right?
Mm-hmm. Choking. You can see in pureed foods as well. Traditional weaning also has choking. When you offer it in appropriate size, appropriate consistency, choking is very, very less.
Okay, that is a typical grandparent worry. You know, we are all that generation. So we get worried. Anyway, that's very nice. It's very, very nicely spoken topic. Congratulate you for this.
Thank you.
A very nice topic, Dr. Gracelyn. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Grace. If there are no more questions, I wish to remind all the audience here to put their attendance in the chat box. And please remember that the attendance must be marked to message, must be to everyone, so that every the attendance can be marked for you. I hope everybody has marked the attendance. If there are no more questions, then we come to the end.
Dr. Priya, I have only one point to add.
Please, sir.
We request our members to send cases and, you know, any interesting topics that they like. And we are interested to include two such presentations every month. So all our members are encouraged to fill up. You know, we have now 3 months locked up. April we have done, May and June is finalized. So I would like more people to volunteer and fill the slot for the next 12 months.
So please add that any member is eligible because they are a member of IMA Kodambakam.
Yeah, so thank you, sir. That is the important one. And we had Dr. Vijay Sundar and Dr. Grace present in those slots today. So we do have slot, I mean, from as Larson sir mentioned, from May, June, even for July, I have sent the topics. So we'd be happy to receive those topics from you.